Alright, so there's this movie I caught way back at Sundance that's finally out called Blindspotting, and I highly recommend it. Obviously, there's a bunch of these Hot Topic issue movies that are being produced. You know, I've seen a dozen of them this year, and while I like the messages in them, you know, I'm not just going to be one to give it a pass just because it's covering something I agree with. Like, obviously, racism is no good. Like, most people would agree with that. But that doesn't mean that just because your movie says that, that means that your movie is a good movie. That would be like loving a bad song just because it reminded you not to kill yourself. Who can relate? Woo! Blindspotting overall, in my opinion, was pretty great, so I highly recommend it if you like David Diggs from Hamilton rapping on the spot. It's got that Michael Peña story mode thing that he does in Ant-Man, but way better in a scene in this one. Watsky's in it, Wayne Knight from freaking Space Jam is in it, and Peggy. And overall, I think you should watch it because I'm gonna spoil the ending, and I think it's one that's worth talking about. Some people are thinking it's a little corny, but I kinda liked it. Let me explain. So the movie takes place in Oakland and is written by two buddies who grew up together and stars those two guys as two buddies who grew up together. Colin is on his last days of probation after helping his Dennis the Menace of a friend named Miles, who's actually the reason why he's in jail to begin with, because he was defending him. So not only is he the Hobbs to this Calvin who's out of control, he has a girl who refuses to be his girl, and then this happens.
Stop!
Now, obviously, things get complicated. Since it takes place in Oakland, there's a big focus on gentrification, which my stupid cartoon self thought it had something to do with genres, but the quick animation explanation of it would be that you have a spot that's full of low-income folks, and a bunch of hipsters come in who want to set up these gluten-free, non-gendered, consensual coffee shops, and then it raises the prices of all of the surrounding areas, causing the people who were initially there to not be able to afford it. They get pushed out, and then bigger companies or richer people come in, take over, just because they saw my tia's crumbling panaderia and thought it looked cool.
I got locked up for 15 years. I used to be just like y'all. Check your own potential, man.
Actually, sorry to interrupt.
Let's go to brunch! Ah, I got
what happened to Brooklyn?
Brooklyn!
It's tricky, though, because, like, obviously you want places to get better, but, you know, we all know vibranium doesn't exist, so you can't exactly get that Black Panther ending where they just come in and make a place better. You know, you would need an individual that has a lot of extra money. But sadly, most of the times, it ain't really, you know, people coming in to help. They just want to take over. Hence why I go to Pilsen for quesadillas and get met with matcha lattes. It's interesting, however, how the movie still focuses on the people going through the shift, right? It's not just blaming everything around them, but it's showing how they react to it. How sometimes they get blind spotted. Because even though he has an entire history with this one person, the only thing that she can see is that big mistake that he made. It's kind of like that optical illusion vase thing. You know, your brain automatically is either going to see a face or a vase first. Unless you binge Rick and Morty and you're intelligent enough to see both. But that's something we see all the time, right? There's the dress, there's Yanny or Yanny. Either you look at this image and you see a goat or you see a turd. But in the movie, it's dealing with a person's reputation, right? A lot of celebrities nowadays may be getting blind spotted for the past. But in this one in particular, you're seeing Colin, who's a guy who can't move on from a mistake that he made, because he was actually helping his buddy. What's interesting is that Colin, by the end of the movie, is actually doing some moving business for the police officer who shot the innocent dude who he saw die in the beginning of the movie. And that's where this whole rap monologue comes in, because I like the guy, right? I've seen him and his group clipping, so the whole rapping works for me. I can see how others may think it just randomly turns into a rap school musical. I thought I got the point across, especially when you consider that this cop blind spotted another individual who he just assumed deserved to die and he killed him. But now that Colin is put into the position of power where he has control and he can exact revenge like Carrie with her exes, he decides instead to just rap out his frustrations to make a point. That he's not going to become the image this guy thinks of when he first looks at him. A killer. That's what kind of stuck out to me. That's why I thought it worked. You know, it's one of those movies that may have a message, but it's not one of those movies that's forcing the answers down your throat. Instead, kind of just making you question things. Such as, are you blind spotting someone, or are you the one being blind spotted? Thank you guys for checking out this video. I'm curious to know your thoughts. I know this is one of those that, surprisingly, you can see it because MoviePass may be tanking. I'll have a video on that soon. But at the same time, I guess they got stock in this because MoviePass, this is like one of the few movies MoviePass is actually promoting and allowing you to see. So I would say check it out. I saw it at Sundance. There's another one at Sundance called Monsters and Men, which I highly recommend. I'm not sure when that one's coming out. Sorry to Bother You was also another good one. You know, it's interesting to see all these perspectives of like, you know, hot topic issues that are happening, and seeing how it can be done as a drama, how it can be done as a comedy, and just the different perspectives people can bring to it. I'm curious to know your thoughts down below if you checked out this movie, if the rapping works for you, who your favorite character in Hamilton is, and don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll send you Barbecue Becky's number.